Hello, I'm Augusta McKay Lodge, a violinist with Voices of Music, and today I'm talking about the basics of video recording. I will discuss all the steps required in creating a stellar video performance, including the equipment needed, the setup and preparation, and finally, the actual recording process. The first thing to do is to choose what you would like to record. This should be a piece that ticks all the boxes. It makes an artistic statement, it contributes to the very large amount of video content that is already available, and compares favorably and competitively to this content. It has audience appeal, and it is something that you love playing and which gives you confidence. Another thing to take into account is whether this is a well-known top hit kind of piece, or whether it is a lesser-known gem that you would like to bring to light. It's great to video both kinds of repertoire. After you've chosen your project, you of course have to practice and prepare the piece. And ideally, you've prepared to such a high level that it's no problem to record a full take. Even though you can edit in post-production, and certainly you will want to record multiple takes, it's always good to have the full run-through for an organic and fluid impression. These days, it doesn't take a lot of equipment to make a stellar video. Smartphones are now equipped with wonderful cameras, so if you don't own a video camera, you can always still record with your phone and the result will be lovely. You will need at least one good microphone, which can be a small one that you just attach to your smartphone and record via an app. And another must-have is a really good set of lights, which can help to avoid issues such as a dark room. You will also need a tripod, ideally one that's quite high, quite tall. So you'll need this for your camera in order to achieve the desired angles and framing. And finally, think about the space that you are filming in. It should be a good setting both visually and acoustically. So if you're filming in your home, you do want to try to declutter as much as possible, which I know is very difficult, but it just helps to avoid these visual distractions from your beautiful performance. For a multi-angle video, you can choose one of two approaches. Either you set up two or three or more cameras or devices simultaneously in different positions, or you can film multiple takes and move one camera to a new location, a new angle, between each take. The latter can be a bit more time consuming, but it's definitely the cheaper option. And if you go with the former, just take care that you don't see any of the other equipment, whether it's cameras or microphones, in your shot. And finally, if you're recording all on your own, I advise marking your position with tape on the floor or some kind of marker, so that when you're back and forth between playing and pushing buttons, which you will be, that you don't accidentally migrate too far from where you were originally standing. Now you have the equipment, so you can set up and begin to record. We're getting closer. The first thing to do is a test run the day before. This is really your chance to identify and fix any issues, either, well, it could be issues during the process, like forgetting to push record, which I have done before, or even looking over the footage afterwards. So are you happy with the lighting? Are you happy with the framing, with your outfit? And do you feel like your video has highlighted you and your instrument in the best way possible? Always feel free to get a second opinion from friends, teachers, or colleagues. Often this fresh set of eyes picks up on things you might not be able to, since you're doing everything at once anyway. And keep an eye out for the details, for the clutter. Water bottles, stray coffee cups, that's a big one, sweaters. You want a clean space, basically. And framing is everything. Try not to frame your shots too tightly. You want to leave some margin so you have the option to crop the images in post-production if needed. And most importantly, the video resolution really must be in 4K or higher. You don't want to forget that. So do go into your camera or your phone settings and set that immediately. Now you push record and you think you're ready to play. But don't forget one last detail. While you're in the camera frame, in the shot, Clap your hands 2 or 3 times. And this is for the video and audio. If you're using a separate microphone, it gives you a sync reference, which is really imperative for lining your video and audio up later in editing. It totally saves so much time. Record multiple takes. What I usually do is I'll do a full take, a run through, and then I break that up into smaller sections. And then from there, I'll do my patches. So I might have missed a note, or maybe I just want to get like one isolated bar again. I'll do those patches. And then afterwards, I do another full take in entirety for good measure. When recording these smaller sections, it's really great to have a metronome on hand so that if your tempo does fluctuate a lot, you can kind of keep that in check, because that's going to be very hard to edit together organically later on. And similarly, I also keep a tuner on hand so that I can check that my pitch is stable between takes. As you switch angles, get close-up shots. It could be your face or your hands. This can really help with continuity issues in editing, and it also highlights you and your technique. Sometimes when we video, we forget that we are performing, but it's basically all the same rules. No grimaces, no acknowledgement of making a mistake. Ultimately, we want to have fun. And visually, it's really apparent, actually, when someone is stressed or not enjoying their own performance. So I know it's a challenge to switch from recording mode to performing mode, but once everything's set, it's just really great if you can focus on you and your instrument and your wonderful performance. Physically, actually smiling is always good. It's very appealing to the audience, but also it helps you to relax and just to enjoy what you're doing. So those are the basics to filming. And in another video, we will discuss cameras, lighting, and post-production in depth. I really hope this has been helpful. So get out there and record your beautiful music and just have fun with it. Thank you.